Welcome to All Things Mac. I'm your host, Jim Fair. Recording this from a local deserted park and baseball diamond. I'm sitting in the stands all by myself. Yes, I'm practicing social distancing. I came here on my bike, managed to carry all the camera gear and tripod without falling down or having a wipeout, which is nice. So Apple has released 10.15.5, the latest version of macOS Catalina. And why should we care? Well, if you're stuck on one of the new machines that only runs Catalina, you're waiting for every software update, hoping it's going to fix all the bugs and make it more stable. Because when the OS isn't stable, it's pure torture for the user. And Catalina has been torture for long enough. Anyway, there's still lots of bugs in Catalina. I still see occasionally the App Store telling me I don't have any purchases. I see a number of strange things. When you shut down the machine, you might notice the dock will suddenly go whoosh and there's another dock behind it, like the dock process is running twice. So I think they've made some errors there. The dock process should not be running twice. It should not be painting the screen twice. You see a lot of little bugs like this where they draw something on the screen twice and you don't notice it unless you're running on hardware so slow that you can see the animation happening. You know, you may not notice some of these minor things that they'll get to eventually. And so .5 adds a feature, this battery management feature. So if you are on a portable machine, it's nice to have that feature. It's designed to allow you to increase your battery life while reducing wear and tear on your battery, which is all to the good. Other than that, it fixes bugs, and that's what we would expect it to do. If you have a large external RAID, this may be welcome. In fact, I have one of those on my desk at work, although I haven't been to work since mid-March, so I'm working from home now. Bug fixes are a good thing. So if you're on Catalina .4, I highly recommend upgrading to .5. You might want to wait a day and just make sure there's no awful showstopper bugs. Sometimes these things happen, very rarely, because they do a public beta. And I was running the public beta and didn't see any issues, or any new issues, I should say. So it's still not going to run a lot of software. It's still incompatible with 32-bit code. So you can't run a lot of old audio software, a lot of your plugins, if you're into audio in a big way, may not work. So please check the compatibility of your software before you upgrade and have a full backup. Ideally, a Time Machine backup and maybe one other. Redundancy is good, especially in backups, before you make the leap to Catalina. So, as I said before, it's not my favorite OS, but I'm starting to use it a bit more as it becomes more stable. So I have one machine on my desk running Mojave. The next machine beside it is running Catalina. And I switch back and forth between the two machines. So eventually it'll all be nice and stable and we can stop bugging Apple about fixing all the bugs. You know what they used to do when Steve Jobs was alive is they every three or four releases they would stop. They would do a new release without changing, without adding any features. They would just concentrate on performance and bug fixes. And I think it's time for that to happen again. But, you know, Apple's a big company and they should know what they're doing. I also have to wonder if some of the architects of macOS are no longer there. Have they moved on? Have they retired? Have they moved on to other companies? There's a fellow I used to know there. He was part of Apple Canada back when I worked there. And he emigrated to California with his girlfriend. And I think in the year 2001 and 2, he was, fairly high up in the company, and he appeared in a couple of Steve Jobs keynotes. So he wasn't exactly a friend of mine. He was more of an acquaintance. We chatted through one of these Apple dinners one day, and my wife and I made them feel at home. But aside from that, you know, I just wonder, I don't think he's at the company anymore. So a lot of the people who know the history of the Mac are gone. And I start to worry when I see things disappear from the shortcuts. So a shortcut I've used for years and years is you double click to select a word. Now, if you're doing this in the dialog box, Command K, connect to server. And if your servers are all something dot something dot something dot something, each of those things is a word, right? So if you can double click, you can select just that word and type in something different. If all your servers end in the same domain name, for example, you can easily create a bunch of shortcuts for all your servers. Well, now that feature seems to disappear at random. So instead, when I double click, I'm getting the whole line selected. That should be only when you triple click. And you know, after a while you get used to certain ways of doing things, certain command keys. You know, I'm always using Command O to open things, Command W to close, Command Tab to switch applications. And these things have worked since the advent of before OS 10. In System 7, these things worked. Tunneling, another thing. You hold the Option key down and you're tunneling down into different folders. Or if you're doing a drag and drop of a file, you can hover over a folder and after a moment it will open. And then you can hover over a subfolder and after a moment it will open. And then you can copy to a folder that you didn't even have on the screen. This is a great feature. That's still there. But these are the things I worry about as the OS gets older and Apple young engineers come up who don't know the history. They may see this code and go, oh, why is this in there? Rip it out. Make our thing 10% faster, you know. So, you know, performance and features, there's always a bit of a balance there. But as the hardware gets faster, the OS tends to get more bloated. And then if you're using the same hardware and you've gone through three or four OS upgrades, you're finding the OS is too slow on your hardware. This is another reason why it's sometimes advantageous to downgrade to an older version of macOS. Anyway, I'm rambling on here a little bit. It's hot. I will say goodbye for now. Thanks for watching and fade out.